When using multi-threaded applications, problems can sometimes occur when more than one thread is inside the same method. In this example, I have a program that simulates withdrawing money from a bank account. So first, I have a class called BankAccount. This has a field called Balance, which represents the amount of money in the account. Then there is a second field called Overdraft, which represents the overdraft limit. The constructor takes a number for the overdraft as an argument. There are also methods to top up the account, debit the account, get the balance, and get the overdraft. Secondly, I have a class called ATM. This has a method called withdraw, which takes two arguments. The first is the account the money is being withdrawn from, and the second is the amount to be withdrawn. It then checks if the amount being withdrawn would take the money in the account over the overdraft limit. If it does, then it prints out a warning message and doesn't remove any money from the account. Otherwise, it debits the account by the amount specified. Finally, I have a class called Users. This class has an account with an overdraft limit of $50. In the main method of the class, I firstly top up the account with $100. They have $100 in their account and an overdraft of $50, so they can spend up to $150 without being overdrawn. In this example, I am assuming that one account can have two cards associated with it. So there could be a scenario where two people try to withdraw money from the account at exactly the same time. To represent this situation, I have two threads running at the same time. In the first thread, T1, someone goes to an ATM and tries to withdraw $100. And the second person also tries to withdraw $100 from the account. I start running both threads at the same time to see what happens. When I run the application, the output shows that the current balance is minus 100, but the overdraft limit is $50, so something has gone wrong. If I look again at the withdraw method in the ATM class, I can see what might have happened. The first thread has entered the withdraw method and called getBalance. This returns $100 because that is the amount in the account to start with. It then moves on to check if withdrawing the money from the account will make it overdrawn. At this point, the second thread could have entered the method and called the getBalance method. Because the first thread hasn't yet withdrawn any money, it also returns $100. So both threads are able to withdraw $100 each, taking the account balance below the overdraft. There is no knowing which order the threads will execute the lines in the method in, so sometimes it may work perfectly fine, but sometimes, like this time, it doesn't. This may seem like a complex problem to solve, but it's actually very simple. All I have to do is add the synchronized keyword to the signature of the withdraw method right before the return type. This means that now only one thread can enter this method at a time. So the first thread will enter the method, get the balance which will be $100, then withdraw $100. So the balance is now $0. The second thread can only enter the method when the first thread has finished. So when it calls the getBalance method, it will be $0. Withdrawing $100 would take it over the $50 overdraft limit, so the transaction would be denied. If I rerun the program, I can now see that it works as intended. It is now impossible for both threads to enter the withdraw method at the same time. So synchronized methods are a simple and effective way to stop threads from interfering with object data at the same time.